acknowledge God in prayer. In the pattern of the Lord's Prayer, the first insight that we gained was that we must relate to God as our Father. It's a very special and an intimate way of approaching God. And the next insight is from Matthew chapter 6 and verse 9. It says, "In this manner, therefore pray, our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name." One of the things that's important for us when we approach God is to know who He is. Hallowed be thy name. You know, the name of God. The nature of God is revealed in His Word. The nature of God is also revealed in His name. God revealed Himself with various names to the people of Israel. We read that God revealed Himself as Jehovah Jireh, the provider. He revealed Himself as Jehovah Rapha, the healer. He revealed Himself as Jehovah Nissi, our victory banner. He revealed Himself as Jehovah El Shaddai, the all-sufficient one. He revealed Himself with various names, Jehovah Sitkenu, Jehovah Shalom, the Lord our peace. And so when we approach God with an understanding of who He is, it really deepens our prayer. We know who we are praying to. We are able to acknowledge the person of God. We are able to acknowledge the nature of God. We are able to acknowledge the power of God. And we are able to pray effective prayers. We are not coming from a place where we are saying, "I'm not sure what God is able to do. I'm not sure what the will of God is." But we are coming from a place where we are saying, "God, I know you are fully able. God, I know that you are fully willing, oh God, to do these things for me. God, I'm coming from a place where I know your heart for me. So I'm coming to worship you. I'm coming to spend quality time in your presence." So we can use this insight in our everyday life. We can use it whenever we pray. After having approached God as our Father, we can spend some time knowing who He is through His name. We can hallowed His name, which simply means that we are lifting up the name of God. One by one, we can say something like, "God, thank you that you are my Savior. Thank you, God, for salvation. Thank you for every victory that you have brought into my life, oh God. Lord, I lift up your name." You know, Philippians 2 tells us that the name of Jesus is above every other name. Jesus humbled Himself, and therefore God gave Him a name which is above every other name. So we can come into the presence of God and lift up the name of Jesus. We can just spend some time in saying a thank you for the powerful name of Jesus. And let's be sure that as we do this, you know, the way we are praying is changing. The way we are approaching God is changing. And the way our expectation is before the Lord is also changing. You know, we are fully aware that this is a God who is all powerful. This is a God who is our Redeemer, and He is able to restore, He is able to strengthen. And it's almost like we can hear the voice of God say, "Fear not, now I am your God and I am with you. I will never leave you. I will never forsake you." And shall we just pray right now and acknowledge and hallowed the name of God? Heavenly Father, we thank you, God, for this privilege of coming into your presence. God, thank you that we can come into your presence anytime, oh God. The veil is torn, and any moment we can approach your throne of grace boldly. And God, we just lift up your name, oh God, and we thank you for who you are. Lord, we praise you for the name of Jesus. We praise you for the powerful name of Jesus, oh God. Father, we thank you for your names, God, that reveal your nature. We thank you that you are a Redeemer, provider, our victory banner, oh God, all sufficient one. And God, we know that even as we praise you, God, that Lord, we are being changed, oh God, that our lives are being changed this very moment. We bless you and we honor you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.